Upon launching the program, you'll see Project Gallery, where you can select pre-designed templates to get you started quickly, or choose a recent project. We'll start by taking a look at the main window. It contains the Library panel to the left and the Program Inspector to the right. With the help of the View button, we can hide, show, or detach the necessary panel. Now let's take a closer look at the Library panel. There are three tabs here: Object Library, which includes the building elements and furniture; the Material Library, with all the supplied materials; and the Project Tree. The Project Tree is a breakdown of all of the objects included in the given project. Here you can control an object's visibility, as well as lock and unlock it. Next, we have the Toolbar. In case the supplied 3D objects aren't enough, you may use the Import button to add objects from a file or directly from the Trimble 3D warehouse. The Share button allows you to export the results into popular file formats or share the views and movies created in the project with your friends on YouTube, Facebook, or Twitter. Next, we have the 2D tools. From left to right are located the Selection tool, then the drop-down with the Straight and Arc Wall tools for drawing walls, the Room tool for creating complete rooms, the Floor, the Ceiling, and the Opening tools for creating custom floors, ceilings, and openings. The auxiliaries contain Dimension and Annotation tools, as well as Camera and Movie tools for adding user cameras and creating videos. We also have Pan and Zoom tools. The button near the Zoom tool allows you to switch the type of 2D representations from a vector shape to an auto-generated raster image. Note that the toolbar is fully customizable. By right-clicking on it, you may select Customize Toolbar from a menu, and then Add, Remove, and rearrange the toolbar buttons to suit your work style. To the right, we have a Program Inspector, but we will get to that in a second. The next three buttons change the mode you work in. There is the 2D view for creating floor plans, the 3D view for viewing and refining the interior, and split mode, which is a combination of both. The 3D tools include a set of movement tools that allow you to walk through, look around, and fly through your project. But there is also the option of using the movement wheel, which is in the lower center of the 3D view. Live Home 3D offers two rendering modes for the sake of convenience and flexibility: Shadows and Lights On, and Shadows and Lights Off, which is the faster of the two options. Now let's get back to the inspector. The first tab contains object properties where you can control the characteristics of walls, furniture, columns, and other objects. Next, we have the Materials tab, which controls what materials are applied to objects. In the 2D Properties tab, you can alter the appearance of the floor plan and the objects there. The Cameras tab contains all of the cameras in the current project. Here you can add, delete, and switch between user cameras and movie tracks, as well as record movies. The Light Properties tab contains the controls to adjust the light sources, including the sun and moon. You can also change the external environment. Next tab is Building Properties. This is where the new stories and auto roofs can be added and deleted. You may set the common height of the stories and adjust other parameters here. And finally, we have the Project Settings tab. This is where you can select the default measurement units and scale, as well as define the project preview. Now, let's take a quick look at the Program Preferences. The options in the 3D Settings tab control the 3D rendering quality and the program performance. The Import and Export tab offers options for imported and exported objects. And finally, the Miscellaneous tab handles things such as the autosave functionality and snap sensitivity on 2D plan. Now, to make work much quicker for yourself, take a look at the Program Help to learn about shortcuts connected with many of these actions.